guys. This is Vince Carter with Elevate 209. We're here at the HIP, the Home Improvement Project. Get ready to get it. So I wanted to bring you guys into me a little closer, a little more intimate, a little more communication in a sense of you get to see the athletes all the time, but you never get to maybe hear them or hear me talking a lot or seeing the relationships we have, the interacting, and because that's what it is here. It's a family. So I want to make sure you guys can see that, can feel it. So today we're going to be starting our first day of the VC blog. So make sure you guys subscribe, like, comment, do all that stuff. Let's go. Cool? How you been feeling? You know, we got Johnny over here. He's a veteran.
Say hi, Johnny.
What's up? 209 going.
Let's go to John. Let's go to John.
John, remember that old saying that you had? Come on, stand you up. So I met Johnny. Oh, how many years, Johnny?
15.
At least. So Johnny's one of the guys I didn't think was going to stay around. And he's been around. He's a stud.
He's still day to day.
Tell him your famous saying.
It's a marathon. It's not a sprint. You remember that, you're going to be way ahead of the game. Stick to that.
So, at 10 o'clock, I normally work out with the guys. It happened over Corona. So Corona had me at home for like a month and a half, and I started getting back into really focusing on myself. And physically, spiritually, it kind of just opened up a whole nother wave of training, the way I look at training, the way I feel. And so I made it a staple for me at 10 o'clock. I always work out with the college guys or whoever comes at 10, and it just, I don't know, the kids love it, I love it, and it just does something to me inside. So you're gonna see us get down today. We're gonna do a little bit of agility, a little bit of plyometrics, and then we're gonna die. Right, Chris?
That's right, that's what we're here for.
How long you been here?
Been here since 2013, 2014, 8th grade summer, you know what I'm saying, right before high school. Just came to get right, you feel me?
Yeah, man.
So a lot of people don't know, he's on the first video, the Shelter in the Storm that CrossFit did. He's the superstar on there.
One of them.
Coach Vince like a Cadillac. Like an old school one I had when I was in 8th grade. I was driving in 8th grade.
In 8th grade?
Pretty much. Yeah,
everybody was driving.
Like 14.
Yeah.
That's crazy. My mom taught me heck early.
You was driving stick. Yep.
What?
He can't
drive stick.
Yes, no.
He can't drive stick.
Here, let go.
Yeah, That's how it works, right? Just let go. Good to go.
The first time I drove was to Frisco. It took me about an hour and a half.
That's the worst place to drive stick.
Yeah, because I had to stop on the hills. I was like, oh my gosh.
Put that rubber in neutral. And it rolled down.
Back then, I was probably like a sophomore when I started driving stick. My mom had like a little stick shift. She's like, you want to use my car? You got to learn how to drive stick. Warm up. You know, we start off with 400 meter run. Then we go into more of like the stretches and the moving around, especially for me. I've been injury free, thank God. And as you get older, you know, injury is prone to happen.
You're saying warming up is important, Coach.
Oh, warming up is saying. The key. And I tell people all the time, you know, some people say, oh, my coach said we don't have to warm up or stretch. And I look at them, I'm like, well, read the Bruce Lee book, okay? Spider-Man. You know, I've always been a firm believer in your body's like a vehicle, right? So if you jump in your vehicle without warming it up, after a while, it's gonna start breaking down because you want everything up. So in the sense of your oil, your fluids, your engine, it's all gotta be running for a while so you can get the maximum output of it, right? So our cars are like Ferraris, Lambos.
Well, your car's like a Ferrari.
I'm a Corvette.
You a Corvette?
Yeah. LS3. Stick shit.
Local, big time rappers.
Tanny May. Go by Leaky Ball. Oh.
Set, go, it's 1-2. Get out.
You guys working hard.
So we did a little bit of agility. It's normally what we start off with. It's leg day. We're gonna do some core right now. Just some high reps with torque throws against the wall. So you're generating force as you turn your torque. A lot of sports is moving side to side. So we like to incorporate a lot of things like that. Gets the athlete to feel more familiar with turning like that, more confident. As well, we're strengthening the core, and that's number one. 5 seconds. More of the more. Coach, everybody knows how Coach Carter talks. They'll get it. More of the stuff that
there's more good stuff, right? More good stuff?
Most definitely, but I gotta say it my way, Chris.
Sorry. I'm just the camera guy.
it's gonna be some empty sleds, it's gonna be some box jumps, it's gonna be some lunges, barbell lunges. I like barbell lunges. I like to make sure we're working our hamstrings, our glutes, especially for all the athletes. In this class, you got basketball, you got football, you even got a couple baseball guys, you got a superstar rapper, and you got a trainer. So we do it all. The final round. That's the name of this workout. The final round. Everybody's good. One round to the 10th, 11th. But that 12th round, that's where it is. The final round. Get up. Get knocked down a lot. You gotta get up. That's one of these. It's one of the workouts right here. Keep you how to get up. Teach you. Get up to get knocked down. That's called the final round. Two left, cool down. Put all the stuff away. Good work. Easy day.
Let's go.
Good job, bro. Get it. Long matter. Good. Cold feet. See?